morning students. So let us continue with the last video. In the last video I was explaining about the Culpepper's oscillator. So let us continue with that. So I have already explained the amplifier circuit which I have rigged up on the circuit board. Now we shall see the feedback network. So feedback network consists of two decayed capacitance boxes and one decayed inductance box. So this I have treated it as C1 and this as C2 and this as the inductance L. Okay, so you have to connect the polarities as shown in the manual. So the positive of C1 should be connected with the positive of the inductance. So you can observe here the positive of C1 is connected with the positive of the inductance box, and from either one of these one more wire should be taken and connected to the coupling capacitor. So I have taken one more wire here and I have connected to the coupling capacitor. You can observe here I have connected from positive of the C1 here to the coupling capacitor, to the input. Okay, then the C1 negative should be connected with the C2 positive. Here you can observe C1 negative is connected to the C2 positive. Okay, and then inductance negative should be connected with the C2 negative. So inductance negative I have connected with the C2 negative. And here we have to short between C1 and C2. You need to observe here C1 negative and C1 positive, both in between it is grounded. So amplifier circuit ground should be shorted with this and you have to make the ground. So this is very, very important connection. If you miss this connection to ground between C1 and C2, you may not get the oscillator output. So don't forget to connect the ground between C1 and C2. Here you can observe here C1 negative I have connected to the common ground of the amplifier circuit. So this completes the connection of the feedback. Now let us see. So I have applied 10 volts DC supply here, that is plus VCC. I have given 10 volts. So this is the oscillator output you are getting. Okay, so here you need to measure the frequency of the oscillator. So how to measure the frequency? So to measure the frequency, see, output is measured across the collector of the transistor. So I have connected the probe, positive of the probe, across the collector of the transistor here, and negative to the ground. So this is the waveform we are getting now. So how to measure the frequency? To measure the frequency, first we need to calculate the time period. So how to calculate the time period? Time period is nothing but the distance between the two peaks, okay, two positive peaks. You can observe here this is one peak and the next peak is here. So between these two positive peak, how many divisions are there, we need to calculate. See, you can use this X position button to move the waveform left to right, and you can use this Y position to measure the to move the waveform up and down. Okay, so using these two knobs you can set the waveform here. See, one of the peak I have made at this center of the scale, okay, and another peak is now here, okay. So keep one of the peak exactly at the center. So from there, this is the origin, zero. From here, the next peak, okay. So you can observe here, this is one division is there. Okay, this is one division. One division into here, you have to observe now time per division knob. You need to observe. See here, the time per division, it is pointing at 10 microseconds. Okay, this is in microsecond, so this is pointing at 10 microseconds. Okay, so now 1 division into 10 microseconds. That is, first calculate t. T equals 1 into 10 microseconds. So it becomes 10 microseconds. So 10 microseconds is the time period now. That is, one cycle is equal to 10 microseconds. So f is nothing but 1 over t. So 1 over 10 microseconds. How much? 1 over 10 is 0.1, you will get. So micro, if it goes to numerator, it becomes megahertz. Now let us multiply 0.1 with 1000. So remaining is kilohertz here. Okay, mega is nothing but 10 to the power of 6. I am multiplying 10 to the power of 3 with the 0.1. So 0.1 into 1000. Here you can observe 0.1 into 1000 gives us 100. So it is 100 and kilohertz. So 100 kilohertz is the frequency. And in the design also, we have taken the 100 kilohertz. Okay, we have designed the circuit for the 100 kilohertz. So we are getting that much frequency. Okay, here the capacitance value C1 and C2 are 1.2 nanofarad. Okay, but in the decayed capacitance box, here nanofarad is not present. Okay, so 1.2 nanofarad is equal to 1 kilo picofarad. Okay, so you can observe here, it is 1 kilo picofarad is there. So which is at zero now, point this to 1. So 1 into 1k picofarad means it is 1 kilo picofarad, and remaining all the terminals are at 0 position. Okay, similarly in C2 also you can observe all the remaining terminals are pointing to 0, whereas this 1 kilo picofarad I have kept at 1. So 1 into 1 kilo picofarad is 1 kilo picofarad. And inductance we have to give 4 millihenry. So observe here, this is 100 microhenry, which is 0. I made it 0. This also I made it 0, all the remaining. So this is at 1 millihenry. So if I keep this terminal to 1, 2, 3, 4 at 4, 4 into 1 millihenry is 4 millihenry. So we need to set according to the designed values like this. So for the designed values, we got the designed we got the frequency of 100 kilohertz. So this completes the Culpit's oscillator. Next we move to crystal oscillator. Crystal oscillator, I have already rigged up the circuit of the crystal oscillator, so which is as shown in the manual. So this is the amplifier circuit, which is same as the Culpit's oscillator. So the connections here are same. The only difference is there the feedback network consists of two capacitance and one inductance, but here the feedback component here is the crystal. So we are using a crystal of 2 megahertz that should be connected between the base and the collector of the transistor. Okay, so you can observe here, this is the transistor, so this is the base and this is the collector. So in between the base and the collector, I have connected the crystal. So this is the crystal oscillator. So on the crystal oscillator, you can observe here 2.000 megahertz is written on the crystal. So it is 2 megahertz crystal we are using. Okay, so how many hertz frequency crystal we are using, that much frequency oscillation we should get on the CRO. Okay, so we are using here 2 megahertz crystal. So remaining all the connections are same as the Culpit's oscillator, and output here we are measuring across the coupling capacitor 0.47 microfarad, which is connected to the collector. So this is the collector terminal. Across this 0.7 microfarad is connected, and this is the positive of the output. Positive of the output is connected to the capacitor, negative is connected to the common ground. Now I will switch on the power supply, and I have set this to 10 volts. Okay, so you can observe here no waveform is coming, because if you to get the waveform, you can tune the pot we are using here. Okay, so at the maximum position we are getting the peak. So but this this consists of noise. Okay, so to remove it, slowly you vary the pot and make it clear wave. Okay, so if we vary the pot, we can get the pure waveform. So here you can observe. So you can tune this to get the pure waveform. So if we tune it, we can get the pure waveform here. Okay, so you can observe here the sine wave we are getting. Okay, now let us measure the frequency of this. To measure the frequency, we have to measure the distance between the two positive peaks here, so which gives the one cycle. So here you observe, this is at the center of the scale. So from here to here, it is exactly one division is there. So one division into here, in time per division, it is pointing at 0.5. Okay, it is pointing at 0.5 microseconds. So what is the time period now? First we are calculating the time period. So time period is nothing but one division into 0.5 microseconds it is. So time period we get 0.5 microseconds. So frequency is nothing but 1 over t. So 1 over 0.5 microseconds. So 1 over 0.5 is nothing but 2. Micro, if it goes to numerator, it becomes megahertz. So frequency we are getting 2 megahertz. So the crystal we have used here is also 2 megahertz. So and the output we are getting on the CRO, it is also of frequency 2 megahertz. So it satisfies the design of the circuit. So this completes the crystal oscillator. Thank you students for watching the video.